very warm welcome to the cathedral this evening, including those of you who I know are gathered outside our door. Though we are here, of course, for a very sad occasion. We've gathered together tonight to give thanks for Adam, for all that he's been to his family and his friends, to Rugby League, and to the city and people of Wakefield. I think as you look at the service sheet, those pictures bring back a flood of memories for everyone here, and they highlight for us the tragedy of his sudden and premature death. In the service tonight, a number of people are going to share their memories of Adam with us, and we shall all give thanks and pray for him, and we're going to join our prayers with those of his family, Mo and Ina and Arana, who are in New Zealand where his funeral's taking place. We shall ask God's comfort for them and for ourselves in our grief. So at the beginning of this service, we pause for a moment and we turn to God in prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you because you make us in your image and give us gifts in body, mind, and spirit. We thank you now for Adam, for what he's meant to each one of us. As we honour his memory, make us more aware that you're the one from whom comes every perfect gift, including the gift of eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. We stand to sing the hymn, Abide With Me.
We have a number of tributes to Adam this evening, and I'm going to invite John Keir from Wakefield Wildcats to make the first tribute.
I knew Adam for a relatively short period of time with regard to years and months, but because it was an everyday involvement, I believe I got to know Adam very well. When our paths first crossed, my knowledge of Adam was of his rugby playing ability, a big, fearsome individual who carried the ball with aggression and purpose, and a man who, when he tackled you, you knew he'd been tackled. In short, I knew Wakefield Trinity Wildcats had a very good rugby league player. What I didn't know, and is even more impressive, was the true character of this giant of a man, a character every bit as impressive, every bit as imposing as his stature. I've said this before and I'll say it again, Adam was a true champion of a man and a true gentleman. At our club, Adam was renowned for his hard work, with the view that if it had been done well, work hard and it can be done even better. never one to settle for complacency, never one to settle for comfort. He always wanted and worked to be better, and this rubbed off on everyone around him. Even after one of his frequent outstanding games of rugby league, he always sought to be better. He always sought to improve. That attitude, it also demonstrated another of his many attributes, that of humility. Never one to accept all the plaudits, he wasn't comfortable with that, but he was always one to acknowledge other people's efforts and other people's worth, from the head coach right down to the most junior of players. Those attributes made Adam such a great member of our group and were instrumental in making him a great leader and a very good player who worked hard, wanted to achieve, and very importantly, valued every member of the group and what they contributed. Furthermore, away from the team environment, Adam was always willing to give that most valuable of commodities, time. Time to assist others in the community as a whole, either through our work at Wakefield Trinity Wildcats or, in the wider sense, through his work at the Wakefield Council. But the unit that I believe Adam contributed the most to, demonstrating all the aforementioned core values, was to his family unit, both in New Zealand, but also his immediate family of his partner Mo, his two delightful children, Arana and Ina, all of whom he watched over, doted upon, and loved deeply, a true family man with the highest family values. I've got to stress, these aren't just words. They're how Adam lived his life and how I'll remember him. We've all got memories of Adam on the rugby field. I've got these, but I've got others that I want to remain with me forever. Like the time when Adam used to enter the dressing room and the lunch room for team lunch, and everybody in the room shuffled to allow him into his favourite place. That was the aura of the man. Like the times when Adam would sit with the young players to make them feel at ease. He'd give them fatherly piece of advice. So he was a truly, truly gentle person. And the times he used to like listening more than talking, Adam, but you knew when Adam Wateen spoke, everybody listened. That's how imposing that he was. And the times when Adam used to be on the field after Saturday, kicking a ball or passing it with his son after training, and how the whole of his immediate family, Mo, Arana and Nina, loved match days and always met up in the players' room afterwards, a true family man. But my most abiding memory of Adam is when he swept the boards at the player presentation nights, and afterwards he shook hands with his dad, he hugged his dad, and then just pulled away, and there was a look there between them, mutual pride, love and respect. And he was a man who loved and respected those around him. In conclusion, Adam was a person who touched the lives positively of all he came into contact with. He was a person I was privileged to know. Adam, thanks for the memories. You'll be missed. God bless you.
All the music we're going to hear this evening has particular significance for Adam and Mo and the family. The first piece we're going to hear is By My Side by the Four Corners, and that features Adam's cousin who is singing on the track.
So what's it gonna take to let you know?
Touch peepers, communicating eye to eye, but it's much deeper. Infatuation turned to love, now I must keep her. She speaks her mind every time she talks, and she listens when I teach her. So what's it gonna take for me to let you know I'm with you for real, so I could never let you go. Do my duty, attracted to your mind, power and beauty. Complete defines how I feel when you're next to me. Through these years we hung out like clothes on the line. Some flows I designed changed when you opened my mind. Hoping to find truth in a world full of lies. It's true, I will rise as long as you're by my side. Bottom line is your royal highness, loyal to my chick. And all them other girls getting jealous can get off my tip. I love the way you scream and moan. Let me caress you, undress you, but treat you right, because you're special to me. Life is more than hustle and flow. The satisfaction you hold worth more than money and gold. I ain't the type to let it go, so let it be told. I'm out to give you that strength, heart, knowledge and soul. Lo and behold, I got you by my side when I roll. And you know you're on my mind like wherever I go. I holler, try to express what I wanna show. So tell me what it's gonna take for me to let you know.
So what's it gonna take to let you know?
Every time that you stay down, you warm my mind like every single day I wait around. Just for your smile and the memory don't fade out. This is the time that I show you that it's all real. We catch a fire when we together, ain't no raw deal. I feel alive in my music and when you're here, it's like a force field. You show me love, there's nobody else that I trust. I can never do enough, staying out at the cuff's the main thing. So when you're down, I can be around to change. Don't you worry, I'ma handle that when I come around. Ain't no buster, they be getting sacked with all them other clowns. My perfection is the fine tuning. You told me I could do anything, put my mind to it. And that's the same for you. You know I'm true from the start, never leave you in the dark. You always have a special place in my heart. I make a mark on this world and you a part of it, girl. I'ma start with the thanks that I know you deserve. From the hood to the suburbs, baby, listen and learn. Precision is heard, the way I put my vision in words. This is the verse, I could take away the pain and the hurt. Through our struggle, you can count on me on making it work. I'll be the same till I lay in the dirt. My daddy taught me how to treat a lady. Life is what my baby is worth.
So what's it gonna take to let you know?
I'm now going to invite our Mayor, Councillor Jackie Williams, to give a tribute on behalf of the Council.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my consort and I, on behalf of Wakefield Metropolitan District Council, feel honoured to be able to join with you all at this sad time. We were both shocked and deeply saddened to hear the devastating news of Adam's sudden death. Our thoughts and prayers turned immediately to Moana, Arana and Ina. We can only imagine how devastated they all must be at this difficult time. But we all tonight, as a community, have come together to show our support to the family and friends as they lay Adam to rest in his home country. Now, Adam, as many of you will know, agreed to be our Deputy Mayor's consort earlier this year. Adam showed great enthusiasm for this role and enjoyed meeting many people from various groups and organisations across the district. Our Deputy Mayor, Councillor Heather Hudson, could not have chosen a better person to be her consort. Adam's character, his gentle nature, his ability to talk to people, these are all the qualities needed to be an ambassador for our district. And it is wholly appropriate to call Adam an ambassador. He undertook everything asked of him with a smile and a kind word of encouragement for everyone. He was a great representative for Wakefield, and I can say without hesitation, He would have continued to contribute immensely in his civic role to the work undertaken by both Heather and myself. Adam will be missed by all who had the fortune to meet him during his time as a member of the mayoral team representing this district. I feel humbled to be able to join with so many people here tonight to pay our own tribute to this giant of a man. Adam was husband to one. He was son and father to two. He was a friend and a colleague to many. And he was a hero and a role model to thousands. Everyone here tonight has their own special memories of Adam, some of which we can all share. Others are just for the few, but all of them will be remembered always. This cathedral is full of people from many places and different backgrounds. All have come to say goodbye to someone who will remain special to us all. In our pain and tears, we all share a heartache that cannot heal. But in our minds, we will keep happy memories of Adam for years to come. Through the Adam Mateen Fund, we can all support the family at this difficult time. And I'm sure that a lasting and fitting memorial to Adam will be established so that we and future generations will know how much this gentle giant of a man was loved and respected. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, can I ask that we turn our thoughts to Huntly in New Zealand, where Moana, Arana and Ina are joining with family, friends and colleagues as they say their final farewell to Adam. At this service here tonight, we join with those overseas in remembering Adam. And Adam, if you're watching, as I'm sure you are, I hope you can see how precious you were to them, to us, to me. So, good night, Adam, and God bless.
If you'd now like to stand, we're going to sing "The Lord's My Shepherd." I'm now going to invite Councillor Clive Hudson to come and read our Bible reading, a reading which tells us of God's invitation to each and every one of us, that death isn't the end of our lives, but that he offers to us eternal life, lived with him forever.
Jesus said to his friends, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he was given to me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day.
This evening we come to celebrate the life of Adam, to honour him as a family man. And so I'm going to invite Mariah Poaching to come and speak on behalf of the family.
Oh, there's a few of you, isn't there? Nice. All week I've had one thought in my head that's kept me clear when it comes to making decisions about what to say or do. And my good friend Liz said to me this week, whatever you do, whatever you say, as long as you do it and say it with the best of intentions, then that's all that matters. With everything that's happened this week, I've held on to that. The day that Mo left, the day after rather, I was talking to some of our family friends, Heather and Clive, and I mentioned that I'd already started to think about what I would say here tonight. And we all said we could just imagine Adam sitting here amongst us, sinking further and further down in his seat, rolling his eyes, and just looking really uncomfortable. Adam wasn't a person who went in for all this pomp and ceremony, and as Heather said, he would probably be more embarrassed than anything that everybody was sitting around talking about him. And so to preface what I say to you this evening, please bear in mind that Adam wasn't a man who stood on ceremony, and so neither shall I. Before my left, I asked her, what do you want me to say? What do you think Adam would want me to say or would want us to do on the night? And she said to me, I would like you to thank everybody who has helped me and the kids out this week, which incidentally I'll do at the end. And then she said, as for Adam, that fellow wouldn't want people sitting around crying for him. He'd want to finish this on a happy note. So finish with a happy song. And then she said, he'd want food. Because if it was him sitting here at 7 o'clock at night doing this, he'd be hungry. It struck me all week how we've managed to find moments of laughter in all of this. And I'd like to share with you a phrase I'd come across before all this, but it seems entirely appropriate to share with you here this evening. It's a quote by Bill Cosby and it reads, through humour, you can soften some of the worst blows that life delivers you. But once you find laughter, no matter how painful your situation may be, you can survive it. Those few laughs that we've shared this week have gotten us through something that probably would have ruined most people. I have felt so proud of Moana this week. After the first 2 days where the shock and grief worked its way through, I picked her up on Wednesday morning and she was a different person. To coin a sporting phrase, she had her game face on. And rather than it being the other way around, as some people may think, I've taken my cues from her. That girl has gone through one of the hardest moments that her life, or indeed anybody's life, will ever throw at them. But she's pulled herself together, held on for her children, and sorted out matters to effectively close off their lives here. And she sorted out what she needed to be done so that she could take Adam home for a proper burial. She said to me the morning after Adam passed away, I couldn't do this for you. And Mo, I know you're going to watch this at some point, but I need you to know that I didn't do anything for you. My beautiful friend, you did this all for yourself, and I, along with many others, were just privileged enough to stand by you while you did it. This week has been one of the saddest weeks of my life, and my heart has broken so many times for so many different reasons. From getting that phone call and praying the whole way to the hospital that she'd somehow just got it wrong. Seeing that boy and Moana's face in the window at the hospital that day as I walked up. and watching my kids pray over their Uncle Adam as they said their goodbyes to a conversation that Mo and I had just before she left, when she was looking at photos of their last holiday, pictures of the kids and Mo with Adam, and she said to me, "I wonder if we'll ever smile like that again." This week has just been devastating, and dear Lord, if I never have to face another week like that again, it would be too soon. For some of you here tonight, and others who may watch this later, me telling you these things may not seem entirely right or appropriate, but I think it's incredibly important to Mo and Adam, to their kids, their families and friends. There is some comfort in the knowledge that Adam's death has been acknowledged by the outpouring of sentiment from the rugby league community on a local, national and international level. We are all shocked and distraught to know that we have lost Adam Watene, the great prop forward, inspirational teammate, fans' favourite and Cook Islands representative. You all saw that he was a family man. But for those of us who were close to this family, we all knew a good friend, a brother, son, husband, and dedicated father. This time a week and a half ago, my biggest worry was who was going to put out the garbage while my husband was away for the World Cup. And this whole week has put into perspective those silly mundane things that I'd normally worry about. There are people with much bigger problems than you or I. I've thought long and hard about what memories to share with you this evening, memories that I have of Adam and that make him special to us. When I've tried to think about what made Adam so special, it's not particular memories or conversations that I've had with him specifically. I've been walking around my house looking at the pen marks on my wall that his daughter Ina, Princess, did on their very first visit to my house. I've also been thinking about when we went to watch his son Arana play rugby and seeing him look to his dad for advice, or the many times he sat patiently waiting for me and Mo to put the world to rights over several glasses of wine, saying, "Come on, Mum, let's go," and then still having to wait another hour or two for us to finish our last, yet somehow constantly refilled glass of wine. There's not one memory I can share with you that shows how much he meant to us. There's a whole lot of little memories that were nothing, but in actual fact, in light of what's happened, they are something. But most of all, despite what's happened, I felt so grateful to you, Adam, for being the person that you were, for bringing Moana and the kids into our lives, and for giving us that opportunity to spend time with your beautiful family. Like many of you have been doing this week, I imagine, I've been sitting here trying to get my head around all this. I keep wondering how it's going to be when Adam and Mo and the kids aren't there just to pop over and see for a cup of coffee. I think about how everyone will feel when Wakey run out onto the pitch for their very first game of the season and Adam hasn't run out alongside them. Particularly when Wakey play Leeds Boxing Day and the score is Leeds 56, Wakefield 14. Now you're all going to come up to me and rub that on my face on the day when Wakey ends up beating Leeds, aren't you? But actually for Adam that'd probably be a nice touch. But the point I was getting to is whatever the scoreline, it'll make it very empty for us watching any match with Wakey and not having Adam there to cheer for. More importantly this week I've been thinking of Mo and the kids and I feel absolutely heartsick for them. Thinking about all the firsts that Mo and her kids and Adam's sisters are going to face without Adam in the coming days, weeks, months, year, and years to come. We each have to grieve for Adam and for his family in our own way and in our own time. I've said to my kids all week, if you feel sad for Uncle Adam, for Auntie Mo and the kids, it's okay to cry. It's okay to feel sad. That actually shows how much you love them and that you care that this has happened to them. There's absolutely no shame in showing that to anybody. But then one of my friends said something to me that gave me a reality check. She said, and I will ask your indulgence for this, but what she said to me was, if Adam was with us watching, and my personal belief is that he is, he'd be really pissed to know that we were sitting around here and feeling sorry for ourselves, that we were wasting our lives agonizing over this when we could be living a life that he just doesn't have anymore, that if he could do it, he would gladly trade places with us to say and do all the things that fate or God or whatever you want to call it has taken away from him. If there is one thought that you could take away with you this evening, it's that thought. Mo doesn't want people to stop living and let this consume them. And I know that Adam sure as heck wouldn't either. Groucho Marx said, each morning when I open my eyes, I say to myself, I, not events, have the power to make me happy or unhappy today. I can choose what it shall be. Yesterday is dead. Tomorrow hasn't yet arrived. I have just one day, today, and I'm going to be happy in it. Now, there's been just a few swear words and cheeky little swipes throughout the speech, and I apologise to any officials and church aficionados and those of you with much more delicate sensibilities than myself. But just so you know, me and the Lord have had a lot of really long chats this week, and we're good. Before I finish off by reading a poem my son Bailey wrote for Adam, I would like to say thank you to a few people on Mo and the children's behalf. She asked me to thank their friends and family and neighbours for all their support. I'm not naming you, you all know who you are. She also wanted me to thank the supporters and the entire rugby league family as a whole for their kind words and thoughts. I want to say this without making it sound like a Hallmark card, but it's possible it could still come out that way. But one of the most heartwarming and really humbling things to have come out of this week is just how special our family of rugby league really is. From the Wakey Club, the players, their families, the staff and supporters, to other clubs and their supporters, the RFL and the Benevolent Fund, and even complete strangers who have come forward to do and say the most simplest of things that have brought Mo comfort. I never realised when I was glaring at some supporter for stopping us in the middle of Asda when we've had a banging headache with the three kids a full trolley at midnight after a match, that actually all of that is part of this. So many people have reached out to Moana this week without wanting any kind of recognition for what you're doing, and they've helped Mo out in ways that are absolutely incredible. Moana thanks you. The kids thank you. The extended family and friends of Moana and Adam's thank you. And I know if Adam were able, he would thank you. Lastly, Moana wanted me to say a small thank you to some friends of mine that have helped me out this week. I've had to exercise the babysitting telephone tree so many times this week and known I never had to worry that somebody wouldn't help me. And even more throughout that, my boys have been so special to me this week. I could not have sat with Auntie Mo through all of this if you hadn't been the wonderful men that you are. It's so easy to forget that while I've been with Auntie Mo and the kids through their grief, that actually you're grieving for the uncle that you lost too. Your Auntie Mo wanted me to say a special thank you to you, and she wanted me to tell you how proud she's been of you this week. As I said, I'm going to finish with a poem that my son wrote for Adam, and I hope I can do this justice for you, Bailey. Adam, your life was loving, oh, you were so great. You were ever so caring, you showed no hate. Take care of your family, look after them well. Your death was unstoppable and so hard to tell. It's very upsetting, yet we'll be overcome at least. Please be safe, Adam, and rest in peace.
Gracious God, nothing in death or in life in the world that is or the world that it shall be. Nothing in all creation can separate us from your love. We commend Adam into your loving care. Enfold him in the arms of your mercy. Bless him in his dying and rising again in you. Bless those whose hearts are filled with sadness, that they too may know the hope of resurrection, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Go forth, Adam, on your journey from this world, in the love of God the Father who created you, in the mercy of Jesus the Redeemer who suffered for you, in the power of the Holy Spirit who keeps you in life eternal. May you dwell this day in peace and rest in the presence of God. Amen.
May God give to each one of you and to all those you love his comfort and his peace, his joy and his light in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Mo asked that people would go out with a smile on their faces this evening as we remember with great thanksgiving and love Adam. And so we're going to finish our service with a closing song, Could You Be Loved, by Bob Marley.
Judging.